You need SQL Server if you want to install SharePoint 2013, and in this video I'm going to show you how to install and configure SQL Server. The video is part of a series of 6 videos showing you the installation of SharePoint 2013. I'm going to install SharePoint on 2 different virtual machines, where the left one is used to run Active Directory and the right one is used to run SQL Server and SharePoint. Run Setup from your SQL Server installation media and click Installation on the left side. On the right side, click New SQL Server Installation. Wait until setup has installed the installation support files and click next on the setup support rules. On the next screen you can choose to install a SQL Server feature installation, and after that you can choose the features you want to install for this SQL Server instance. So depending on your needs, you can choose, or you might need to choose, additional features to install. Keep the default instance and click next to review your disk space requirements. And after that you can proceed with the server configuration. Here you need to enter the service accounts we created earlier for the SQL Server agent and SQL Server database agent. And after doing that, you can click next to proceed with the next screen. You can keep the collation settings you see on the top, so you don't need to change them. As you can see on the top, you can enable file stream if you need to. You can change the data directories, and here you can, or you need to add the current user as a SQL Server administrator. Since this is a development environment, I use the SharePoint Setup Administrator in order to keep things simple. Review your installation options on the next screen and click Install to proceed with the installation. So now we are done, and next we can go on with the configuration of SQL Server. At the end, we need to do one more configuration step. The SharePoint setup administrator used to install SharePoint needs two roles in SQL Server, and the roles are DB creator and security admin. So we need to assign them manually. The SharePoint setup administrator needs two roles in SQL Server, so open SQL Server Management Studio and select security logins and double click the SharePoint setup administrator. A new dialog opens and check server roles, and here this account needs DB creator and the security admin role. In case you might ask, this admin role is assigned because this account is used in my development environment, and there I use one account for the installation of SharePoint, management of Windows Server, and management of SQL Server. So what to do next? You can have a look at one of the other videos about software and hardware requirements, Active Directory, SQL Server, Windows Server, or SharePoint 2013. Or you can go to my blog and have a look at updates, errata, scripts, or tips and tricks. As you know, I offer professional SharePoint training in addition to my free training. The SharePoint installation training material contains a PDF guide, and you can use this guide either to manually create a SharePoint form or to automatically create a SharePoint form. And it doesn't matter which form. You can create a 3-tier form, 2-tier, 4-tier, or a development environment. And as I said, you can do it all automatically using up to 46 PowerShell scripts. And if you're stuck in the middle of the installation and have problems, you can use the troubleshooting tips. And of course, there is bonus material included.